expert in escape and evasion, provision and intelligence collector, extra badass at hand-to-hand combat, triple secret agent. She is Lorraine Broughton. Today, we'll analyze Lorraine as a film character to assert if she's a quality LGBTQ+ portrayal or simply a fraudulent role. Let's find out in Queerbait or Good Rep. Hey, my name is Jem, and it's Bi Awareness Week, so go hug any bi cutie you know, and maybe don't invalidate and erase us. Now, to analyze Lorraine, we're gonna be using the Vito-Russo test that sets some points for good LGBTQ+ representation. And because 2016 happened, I added a bonus point to it, because LGBTQ+ fans deserve better. Now, the goal here is not to simply discourage everyone about their favorite characters, but to bring awareness to writers, producers, and creators, since I'm one of them, on how important it is for us, the LGBTQ plus fans, to have good representation and how easy it can be. Number 1. The character is identifiably LGBTQIA+. Yes. It's not made obvious right away, but throughout the movie, Lorraine is shown to have something with two people, a man and a woman. The first is an MI6 agent called James Gascoigne, who's killed right at the beginning of the movie, but it's hinted at that they had some sort of romantic relationship before, through a photo and some flashes. And the second is an undercover French agent called Delphine Lasalle, who tries to seduce her for some information, but Lorraine is too good to fall for that. She does, however, indulge her, and they end up hooking up a few times, with enough pillow talk for it to be more than just a job thing. So yeah, she's definitely LGBTQIA+. Number 2. The character is not solely or predominantly defined by their sexual orientation or gender identity. Yes. Her sexual orientation is never really brought up, other than when her superiors ask about when she made contact with a French agent, which had more to do with the fact that she was a French agent rather than a woman. She's definitely more defined by being a badass agent in an almost impossible mission with no one to trust. So, number 3. The LGBTQ+ character is tied into the plot in such a way that their removal will have a significant effect. Yes. She's the freaking main character of the movie, and it's even named after her. So all there to say, she's all tied up into the plot of the movie. Now, the bonus point that I added. Number 4. The LGBTQ+ character doesn't fall under any harmful trope. Sort of? Oh boy. I was slightly torn, because we're talking about Lorraine and not Delphine, who's brutally killed and she's a queer woman of color, so that's not nice at all. But back to Lorraine. She does kind of, sort of, fall under one very common trope for queer characters. Dead love interest. It's pretty self-explanatory. But Lorraine manages to have two. Both of her love interests are killed throughout the movie. At the beginning of the movie is James Gascoigne, and by the end of the movie is Delphine Lasalle. Now, people die, I know. Especially if there are spies in Berlin when the wall is falling. So that's why I'm not completely throwing Lorraine under the bus for this. But I want to make clear that this is a very specific trope that gets used a lot for LGBTQ+ characters, and it gives off the message that queer couples cannot have happily ever afters. They must always be the ones mourning for the death of their love interest.
Oh, but it's just one movie, just one character.
Not at all. So let me know what you think about this in the comments below. Verdict. I guess it could have been better, but it's decent. And as good as it can get for the first bi lead of a spy movie. Easy fix. Well, let's see. Dead love interest. I mean, if you had to kill James Gascoigne to spark the whole plot of the movie, why not leave the rookie French agent, Delphine, that didn't quite harm anyone, alive? Lorraine said it herself. Percival didn't have to kill her at all. Maybe Lorraine could have gotten to save her by arriving a mere minute before. She would still have been hella angry at Percival for just attempting to kill her, which was the whole point of it. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up, share it with your fandom friends, subscribe and hit the notification bell, please consider becoming a Patron or donating to my PayPal so I can keep doing this type of analysis. Let me know what you think in the comments below, leave your very own fixes for Lorraine if you believe Lorraine or Atomic Blonde needs one, or just tell me what you think about her. So maybe some writer or creator that was thinking of lazily writing a bi-action character with any harmful trope can understand why it matters to have good and believable LGBTQ+ portrayals, and can come up with much better plots for them.